first night camping here at Fort Pillow State Park in Tennessee. It's kind of on the outside of Memphis. Fort Pillow is named after the Brigadier General Gideon Pillow that was promoted, and they were building him a fort here. He never showed up, it turns out, and it also turns out he was homosexual and therefore rapidly demoted, and I don't know what happened after that. Interesting stuff. When with a name like Pillow, who didn't see that coming? If you're ever coming through the Memphis area, this place, Fort Pillow, it was only $10 for the both of us to stay on one campsite. No electric, you know, just a simple basic campsite. And with our two little tents, we could set them up in there quite easily. And they got a full bathhouse with showers and everything. So $10, not bad at all. So how do you think this compares with your adventure so far then?
Oh, it's way better than that.
Really?
Ooh, yeah. That was a terrible adventure.
Just remember to watch out for armadillos.
Oh my god. Now I'm going to be like fucking looking at the side of the road instead of the road.
I mean, I kind of hope we see one just to take a picture or something, but...
He said he sees them all the time, huh? Or hear them all the time. Where's that at in Arkansas?
Yeah, he said that this side of Tennessee and Arkansas, they really start getting all over the place. I guess it's like deer down here, you know, you hit an armadillo. Says it can really fuck up your truck, let alone a motorcycle.
Yeah, one, that groundhog or whatever it was that ran out in front of you, you must have ran out and didn't realize there was a median right there. Turn around.
Well, let's do this, Enfield.
It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly as you walk away from all the fears and all the faults you've left behind. The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see. But I have seen the same, I know the shame in your defeat. But I will hold on hope, and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck. And I'll find strength in pain, and I will change my ways. I'll know my name as it's called again. Cause I have other things to fill my time. You take what is yours and I'll take mine. Now let me at the truth which will refresh my broken mind.
After we partially got through Arkansas, Ren told me that he was having some real trouble with his seat on his Sportster. It was giving him a lot of pain and stuff. So I decided that I'm going to cut out my bed mat and see if I can give him some extra cushion for the ride. Arkansas was a tough state. It was hot, it was buggy, it was really flat in the eastern part right after you cross the Mississippi, but it was cool. We were halfway there, halfway to the Grand Canyon, and it was exciting.
I'm not digging people here so far, dude.
So that white pad you see now on his seat, that's actually
a bed mat that we got back in Kentucky at a Dollar General that we hacked up in the parking lot. So now we're putting additional padding for his seat. It was rough doing this trip on a Sportster. I mean, it's awesome that Ren was able to do it, and it's surely something we will never forget.
Man, don't these bugs have something better to do?
What's that? So tie me to a post and block my ears. I can see where those endorphins threw my tears. And know my cold despite my faults and despite my growing fears. But I will hold on hope and I won't let you choke on the noose around your neck. And I'll find strength in pain and I will change my ways. I'll know my name as it's called again. So come out of your cave walking on your hands and see the world hanging upside down. You can understand dependence when you know the maker's land. So make your sirens call and sing all you want. I will not hear what you have to say, 'cause I need freedom now and I need to know how to live my life as it's meant to be.
How far are you going?
Arizona.
Bet it's hot down there.
City was very impressive, really enormous, and today was one of the hardest days, but we made it through. We actually rode on through the night quite a bit. We made it almost to the Texas border. We were like 13 miles away from the Texas border, and we found the last rest stop in Oklahoma, and we're just like beat, and we're like, screw it, and this is where we stayed. I slept under a tree right in the rest stop. Stay tuned.